Pastor Steve Waldron here, New Life Pentecostal Church in Albany, Georgia. I'm going to talk a little bit about prophecy today. Now, the Bible says in 2 Peter chapter 3, people would actually get kind of sick of prophecy in the end time. They'd say, where is the promise of his coming? You know, we've heard this, and they get used to it. But I'm going to tell you, Jesus is still coming back. Titus chapter 2, verses 12 and 13 says this, teaching us that denying ungodliness and worldly lust, we should live soberly, righteously, and godly in this present world, looking for that blessed hope and the glorious appearing of the great God and our Savior, Jesus Christ. I'm looking for Jesus to come back. I believe in the rapture of the church. I believe there's going to be a trumpet that sounds and the Lord is going to come back. The dead in Christ will rise first, and then we who are alive and remain shall be caught up with him in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. When we see him, we will be like him. After that, there's going to be a seven-year period of horrible things. First of all, this is not a horrible thing. God is going to turn back to the Jews. When you go to Daniel chapter 9, verses 24 through 27, you see that 70 weeks, and this is interpreted as 70 weeks of years, 490 years, is determined upon the Israelites, upon the Jewish people, upon Jerusalem. And then it says that 489 of those weeks, or 483 of those years, or 69 of those weeks, are fulfilled at the coming of Messiah the Prince and his death for the sins of people. So there's one seven-year period out there. Jeremiah describes it as the time of Jacob's trouble. Remember, he had to work seven more years for his second wife, who he really wanted to be the first wife. So the time of Jacob's trouble. So during this seven-year period, there's going to be four series of seven judgments each during this time period. There's going to be seven seals. There's going to be seven trumpets. Seven thunders, which we don't know anything about the seven thunders. God told John not to write about that. And then seven seals, the wrath of God. And so Jesus is coming again. If you don't believe it, look at the signs all around you. Some hints about this, Revelation chapter 11. It speaks of Elijah, and I feel like Moses. They're going to be preaching during the first 3.5 years. They're going to be testimonies to the Jews and others throughout this world. If any man withstands them, fire is going to come out of their mouth. They're going to be killed. Their body is going to lay in the streets of Jerusalem for 3.5 days. And during that time, it says everybody on earth will be able to see their dead bodies lying in Jerusalem. Well, when have they ever had the capacity throughout the entire world till our modern day, through the internet, through Skype, through television, through other means, through electronic media, to see these dead bodies? It's only right now. Revelation chapter 13 says that there's going to be a mark of the beast, and that it's going to be impossible to buy or sell unless one has the mark of the beast. This harkens back to the Roman libelous that you had to have in order to enter the marketplace in the Roman cities. When you had the libelous, it showed that you had done an incense sacrifice to the Roman emperor as unto God. Of course, Christians would not do this, just as people who do know their God would not serve the Antichrist during that period. And it says there's going to be a mark in their forehead or in their right hand. Well, when has there ever been a time where a mark could be in the right hand or the forehead for the buying and selling to show you have made allegiance to the Antichrist? And so that and many other things, globalization, it says the earth is going to be divided into 10 kingdoms, 10 regions, under 10 kings, under the Antichrist. And we're already seeing the regionalization of Europe and of NAFTA and of Central and South America, CETO in Asia, the Africa cooperations on others, South Pacific, these type things. So we're seeing this all set up, and it could happen at any time. During this time period, there's going to be wars. There's going to be billions of people that die through pestilence, through wars. Horrible things are going to come on planet Earth. But if you're living for Jesus Christ, you're going to make it to heaven. Now, I want to point out to you in the scripture we read, Titus 2:13, we're looking for the glorious appearing of Jesus Christ. Paul wasn't looking for the Antichrist. He was looking for Jesus Christ. Lift up your heads, for your redemption draweth nigh. There's far too many people trying to look and see whether this person or that person, this former Soviet leader, is the Antichrist, Gorbachev. Is it Prince Charles? Is it Prince Harry? Is it Prince Juan Carlos of Spain? Many of the other people that say, you know, this is the Antichrist. Quit looking for the Antichrist. Look for Jesus Christ. Also, people are so frightened by globalization and the things that are happening on this earth. I'm going to tell you, your only hope is in Jesus Christ. Your only peace is in Jesus Christ. Love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, soul, mind, and strength. God's able to do miraculous things in this end time hour. I know so many people, and there's nothing wrong with prepping. And the Bible says a wise man sees the evil day approaching and prepares himself thereof. But I'm going to tell you, when things get really bad, you can't prep yourself enough. You can't have enough firearms. You can't have a big enough farm. You think you're going to be protected from that? You got to pay your property taxes. You're not going to be able to. You're going to have to sign allegiance to, you know, those of you that are conspiracy buffs. You remember Day's speech in 1969 to the physicians. Many of you know about that. Where you're going to have to sign an allegiance to the Antichrist. You're going to be just like it was in the early church. So often in the different principalities and municipalities of the Roman church, of the early church, when you got the Holy Ghost, when you got baptized in Jesus' name, you lost all your property rights. You were literally a vagabond and a sojourner. God used that to spread the gospel all around the world. You took joyfully, the book of Hebrews says, the spoiling of your goods. So come on, let's have revival. Get Acts 2:38. That's the only thing that's going to free people from all of this. So many people get so scared about the Rothschilds, the Rockefellers. Hey, do you intercede for those folks if you're scared they're running the world and own the Federal Reserve? You ask God to fill them with the Holy Ghost, see them baptized in Jesus' name. Greater is he that's in you than he that's in the world. Man, nothing can stop the blood-bought Church of the Living God. We are now, as the theology says, and they don't mean this in taking of arms, the church militant. What they mean by that is they mean we're a prayerful church, and we are seeing people born into the army of the Lord, and we have the whole armor of God we can equip ourselves with. The Bible says the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds. So don't get your eyes vertical. You'll get discouraged. Your heart will fail you for fear. Don't get your eyes horizontal is what I meant to say. Get your eyes vertical on Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Let him, he that winneth souls is wise. You will get the Holy Ghost and you'll be witnesses unto him in Jerusalem, Judea, Samaria, to the uttermost parts of the earth. So what I encourage you with this little prophecy moment here today, that yes, prophecy is being fulfilled before our very eyes. Central bankers around the world, people at the Bank of International Settlements in Switzerland and the confabs that they have in Switzerland and Bern and these type places, they're all talking about a cashless society, negative interest rates, how cashless is the way to go, the gradual restriction of cash. You read about it in mainstream publications, the war on cash. It's coming. Prepare your heart. Live for Jesus Christ. You've got a place. What mankind stacks up here, they fill potholes with in the New Jerusalem. That gold, hallelujah. You can worship, dance. Now, I'm not saying be ignorant. I'm saying have your eyes wide open. But having your eyes wide open is this, that you have an angel around you, the angel of the Lord, encamps around about those that fear him. You've got the name of Jesus. God still is in the control of the earth. The earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. The hearts of kings are in the hands of the Lord as the rivers of water. So God is in control of this thing. When the fullness of the Gentiles come in, according to Romans chapters 9, 10, and 11, then
he's going to turn back to the Jews, and not until. Look, the apostolics, we've got a church at the United Nations. Don't you ever think God's not in control of this thing. When President Obama, when he left Reverend Wright's church, he started going to Bishop Brazier's apostolic, one God Jesus name church in Chicago, and took a lot of heavy fire for it because he wasn't going to an Orthodox church. When Bishop Brazier died, Michelle Obama, First Lady Michelle Obama, Valerie Jarrett went to his funeral. Don't you ever think Jesus is not working. Hallelujah. So we're in prophetic times. We are in turbulent times. We're in perilous times. And the perils not only come from the worldliness of the world, but it comes from the insecurities of our flesh that we've somehow got to prepare and look for the Antichrist. Stop. Look for Jesus Christ. You're probably on some list somewhere anyhow if you believe in that kind of stuff. They're going to come round you up and put you in a re-education camp. So stop. And I'm just saying, if you believe in all that kind of stuff. Live for Jesus. Win your neighbor. Win your family members. Have the greatest relationship with Jesus you could ever have. God will bless you even in the end time hour. You can be blessed in a bad place. You're the last leg of the race. God puts his best. He could resurrect Peter, bring him back. He could resurrect Paul, bring him back. Resurrect John, bring him back. He's got you here. He's got confidence that you will unleash his power in this world. We can see miracles, signs, and wonders like never before. And truth proclaimed. God bless you in Jesus' name.